Moin moin YouTube, this is Max and you are watching Random Old School Yu-Gi-Oh! In a pretty unusual setting. Because, yeah, the package I got today is too big for my usual setup. So, we are just going to do it on the ground. And, yeah, without further ado, let's hop right into it. And first thing I want to mention is that I bought this from a store in the US that I bought stuff from before, like 3 or 4 times. And last time, those little packaging things smelled like, like some sort of meat, which I found funny. They do today as well, so I'm not smelling packs or whiffing packs, but those things. Mm. And yeah, but I didn't buy a whole package of those things, but other stuff in it, and this is gonna be like a little treasure search. Let's dig in a little. Oh, okay. Let's see. Ta-da! Number one is something rather unsuspecting. Some of you might have seen one of those boxes on my channel before, and that's because I had like, oh crap, that didn't work out as planned, because I have ordered other ones of those before, and I don't want to open this one at the moment, but I can show you what's inside with one of the other ones. So those are 24 special editions for Force of the Breaker, and the nice thing is that they have Invasion of Chaos booster packs, so 24 blisters equal 24 Invasion of Chaos booster packs, the same amount as in a display, plus I get 2 displays worth of Force of the Breaker unlimited, and yeah, that's a pretty nice thing in my opinion. And yeah, one box of blisters costs, yeah, roughly the same as an unlimited booster display or booster box of Invasion of Chaos alone, so can't go wrong with that, even though it increased in price over the last year, and the first ones I got were much cheaper than this one. I guess this is the last one the shop had, so yeah. They are kind of sold out for this. Let's see what's next. I'm not too sure about what. Ah, there we go. Next up, we have the Lost Millennium Special Edition box. It should be the US version. Yes, Upper Deck. Do, 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 do. Printed in the USA, yes. So this contains 10 special editions with the chance of a Chaos Emperor Dragon promo card, which is the best one in here. Yeah, Invader of Darkness is not too great. And the Ancient Sanctuary versions of Mazera Deville and the End of Anubis in Ultra Rare for this promotion. Yeah, they are kind of meh. But Chaos Emperor Dragon is the big one. Similar to Rise of Destiny, where you have Dark Magician Girl being the big one, and the other three being like, nyeh, I don't care too much. So that's item number two. And the next one should be a little bigger. Oh, I'm gonna spill a lot of this stuff on my floor, I guess. Oh. Last time I bought this, it was packaged in a different way. Oh crap. How am I even getting this out? That works. Move. this one. So, I need some scissors.
Oh my god, I'm on camera.
Drum roll. Yeah. So here we have a grand total of 12 Legendary Collection 1 binder versions. So that's the 2010 print. You can see, I don't know if you can see it. Let's try. Whoop. Nope. Maybe like this. The booster packs shown in here look like the older versions. They don't have the spikes at the top and the bottom to make it easier to rip it open. They have the black and white Yu-Gi-Oh! Letters, not the all white ones. And I think those packs look way better than the new ones, and also the quality of the cards is different. I plan on doing a comparison video between old school packs out of the binder version, the game board version, which I showed you some days ago, and the original printing. I can do that with Dark Crisis, I guess, because I have an open booster box of Dark Crisis, and I can take a pack from there. One out of here and one out of the Game Board edition, and just compare them side by side and check on the differences and stuff. That's pretty much what I got this time. It's quite a lot, and I don't think I will be able to do a purchase as big as this for quite some time. But I ordered this at December 31st, so the last time in 2020, because in Germany there was some something like taxes reduction for 2020 because of COVID, and this ended at January 1st. So when I imported those, I saved like 3% of taxes. And I thought, why not? So I bought all of those items, and hopefully I can open some of them on the channel. I plan to sell some of them in quite some time, maybe when the prices get higher. And some other things I will just keep for my personal collection. So that's it for today. Just a mail day, but I guess the biggest one I have done in a while. And as always, stay safe, stay healthy, and see you next time. Goodbye.